Hi learners, in last class we have discussed about biopotential electrodes. Now let us discuss about pH, PCO2 and PO2 electrodes in this class. The chemical balance of the body is identified by the measurement of the pH of blood and other body fluids. The pH is defined as the logarithmic of reciprocal of the H plus ion concentration. A neutral solution has a pH value of 7. When the value of pH of a solution is more than 7, then it is considered to be a basic solution. And when the pH value is lower than 7, then the solution is to be an acidic solution. Generally, the human blood is slightly basic, such that the pH value of the venous blood is about 7.35. And for arterial blood, it is about 7.40. The next comes the pH electrode, which we are going to discuss. In this diagram, we can see about the electrode, which is of pH. The glass electrode is normally used as a pH electrode. The glass electrode consists of a spherical bulb of 0.5 cm in diameter, which provides a thin glass membrane, which actually permits the passage of only hydrogen ions in the form of H3O plus ions. Inside the glass bulb, an silver-silver chloride non-polarizable electrode is immersed in chloride buffer solution, which is of usually of pH value of 1. The other side of the glass bulb is exposed to the solution of unknown pH. The connection to the potential measuring circuit and solution being tested is completely through a potassium chloride salt bridge and Calomel reference electrode. Today, the glass electrode and reference electrode are available in same enclosure. We have various advantages for glass electrode over hydrogen electrode. The glass electrode is independent of oxidation reduction potential. It is not actually necessary to pass a gas through the solution. Hence, the equilibrium is reached rapidly. The electrode can be used in colored or turbid solution. It gives a small error when we measure the pH for highly acidic solution and alkaline solution. Next comes the PO2 electrode. The oxygen electrode is a piece of platinum wire embedded in an insulating glass holder with the end of the wire exposed to the electrolyte, into which the oxygen from the solution under measurement is allowed to diffuse through the membrane. We can see clearly from the diagram shown here, the bottom of the vessel contains the electrolyte, which consists of a membrane permeable to oxygen, and the top of the vessel is sealed with silver-silver chloride electrolyte electrode is used. Here, the voltage of 0.7 volt is applied between the platinum wire and the reference electrode using a battery. The negative battery is connected to the platinum wire through an ammeter. Reduction of the oxygen takes place at the platinum wire. Now, we will be able to see a process called as oxidation and reduction current is developed, and which is proportional to the partial pressure of the diffused oxygen. The oxygen electrode is also used to monitor the partial pressure of oxygen in biological fluids. Similar to pH electrode, the oxygen electrode is available in the integrated version, consisting of the platinum cathode and the reference electrode in the same enclosure end, and this is called as Clark electrode. We have also have the PCO2 electrode. This PCO2 electrode consists of the standard glass pH electrode covered within the rubber membrane, which is permeable to carbon dioxide. Between the glass surface and membrane, there is a thin film of water. The solution under test, which contains dissolved CO2, is presented to outer surface of the rubber membrane. After equilibrium, the pH of the aqueous film is measured by the glass electrode and interpreted in terms of PCO2 and on the basis of linear relationship between logarithmic of PCO2 and pH of the solution.